Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro, welcome to another tutorial. So in this tutorial, I'll show you guys how you can add transparent header to the latest version of Dawn 13.0.0. I have created multiple tutorials for this. You can find the link in the description below. If you are using 10.0.0, 11.0.0, 8.0.0, or even the older version, the reason why I'm creating this latest version is because you guys are requesting a lot that we want to enable transparent header on the latest version of Dawn theme. So here it is. Make sure to like the video, comment on the video below, which will help me create more valuable content for you guys. Also, don't forget to subscribe. And here is the transparent header. So after implementing this tutorial, you will have it showing up like this. And you will have an option to disable and enable transparent header by going to your customize settings. And as you can see, if I remove this color here, transparent color, and if I uncheck it, you can see that we are back to normal. So that's the normal behavior of our Shopify store. You will just have to check it and your transparent header will be enabled, and you can also change the color as per your theme requirement. So if you are if you have blue color scheme, you can just add in a blue color here and your icons and menu will show up blue color. You can also add in hexa decimal color code. So that's how you can add hexadecimal code if you have a white color to show, or if you have a specific color which you want to show on your transparent header, you can do that by implementing this tutorial. Also guys, the banner you're seeing, the video banner which you are seeing, which is in autoplay mode and continuously playing in loop, you can also set that up. I've already created a video for this. It is not a Shopify built-in section. So Shopify doesn't have a section where you can add video with autoplay and loop feature. They do have the loop feature, but they don't have autoplay feature. So if you use built-in Shopify section, you'll have to click on play button to enable the video, to start the video. But in this section, I tweaked a code a little bit and created a new section in order to add a video which we can use in banner with autoplay feature. Also, if I scroll down, guys, you can see that we have this percent discount showing up. So normally, Shopify shows a sale badge if you have added compare pricing, if you have added discount pricing. So if you are giving up some discount on your product, it will just show sale badge. It will not show percentage of the discount on the badge, which can help you increase click-through rate on your product page, and it will also help you increase sales. So if you want to implement that, I also have created a tutorial. You will find the link somewhere in the screen or in the description below. Okay, now let's start implementing our transparent header. And what I'm gonna do, I'll navigate to backend of my Shopify store. Okay, here's my Shopify backend. I'm going to click on online store. And as you can see, I have implemented that on the latest version of Dawn, which is 13.0.0. And there are a few other codes added in this theme. So what I'm gonna do, I'll install a fresh Dawn theme. So if I scroll down here, I have option to enable Dawn theme. By the way, you can implement this tutorial on all of the free themes. If you're using Spotlight, Refresh, Color Block, Sense theme, whatever free theme you're using, you can implement this tutorial. It's not gonna work on the paid theme. And if you want our help to implement that on your paid theme, do let us know via link in the description, where you can simply fill up a form and request our help for customization. Okay, I'm going to install a Dawn theme. Okay guys, while this Dawn theme is stalling, I would like to give you guys a news that if you are new to Shopify and you are watching this video for the first time, or you are setting up a new Shopify store, you can set up your Shopify store just with $1 per month for starting 3 months if you use the link in the description. So there's a limited time offer. Make sure to sign up through that link if you want to set up your store with just $1 per month. Okay, our latest version of Dawn has been stalled. I'm going to publish that one. Going to click on publish again. And here we go. Our fresh Dawn theme has been installed. I'm going to close all tabs here. And let's preview this theme. Click on these three small dots and then click on preview. So here's the default behavior of Dawn theme. As you can see, there's no autoplay video banner, and you can see the default sale badge. It's not showing the person discount. Okay, so let's implement the transparent header for which I created this video. Now click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. I'm going to open up on a new tab. Before editing the code, guys, make sure to have a duplicate of your theme. In case you add the code wrongly or you mess up anything, you can easily revert back. And please don't blame me if it breaks your theme, because I keep notifying you guys to have a duplicate of your theme. Code customization might not work properly if you are using multiple apps or if you have done already customization. Okay, so here's our code editor. Okay, here's our header.liquid. Here's the header.liquid file, and here's our code tutorial. So in the description of this YouTube video, you'll find this blog post link where you can have all of the code showing up. So you don't need to worry about typing it out manually. You can simply copy and paste. Okay, so here's our header.liquid file. First thing first, we will add this schema code. Okay, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom, and above this blocks and this bracket, I'm going to add another comma and copy this code here, paste it, and remove this comma, and as we don't need that, right? So this comma is very important because we are starting the new schema, and for the ending schema, we don't need the additional comma. So I'm going to update this instruction as well, where I will mention, and I'm going to add some screenshots so you guys can easily add this schema. Okay, after add this schema code, scroll up, and below style tag, which is here, hit enter and go to the second step, which is this. So we will add this code under our style tag. And after adding the schema and after adding this few lines of liquid code, just hit save. And now let's go to customize. So let's click on these three small dots and then click on customize theme. Open up on a new tab. So here's our customized theme. Click on header here. And when we scroll down to the bottom, you can see that we have now option showing up to enable transparent header. Now all you have to do is just check it, and you will be able to enable your transparent header and add in the color for transparent header. Click on save. Now let's preview that in our theme by hitting refresh. Okay, our transparent header has been implemented. Again, if you want to change the colors, you can simply do that by adding any color here. You can add hexadecimal code or any color, whatever you want. Okay, guys, so again, let's test this in mobile version. So here's our mobile layout. And here's how the transparent header looks like in mobile version. But as you can see, if we scroll down, there's an issue here when it doesn't look good. So what I would suggest you guys is to disable the sticky mode when you have implemented the transparent header. So if you go to header, you have this option of sticky header. You can simply select none, and there is a separator line which you can also disable. So uncheck this one. And now let's hit save and let's test it now. So now the transparent header doesn't look weird. By the way, if you guys want me to create a more detailed in-depth tutorial, like I can also add the feature where if you scroll down below the banner, it will automatically be showing up as a default header, not the transparent header. So I can add that feature using some additional JS code. Also, if you want me to add showing up a different logo on transparent header, I have created for my previous version. I haven't created yet for this version because we have been creating multiple tutorials for you guys, as you guys have been commenting a lot on my channel, and we are focusing more on the requests which you guys are making. And we are also in progress of creating a tutorial for wishlist without app, so you will be able to add wishlist feature without app. And if you want me to add different logo on scroll in transparent header, comment down different logo in this video so I will understand that how many people are demanding this request, demanding this tutorial, and I'll be able to create more advanced tutorial on this. And that's it, guys. So we have added transparent header, which look good on desktop and mobile version. So that's our transparent header. And if we check that in mobile version, that's how it looks. Cool. And if you want this transparent header to be enabled throughout your website, not just the homepage, by the way, my suggestion is not to go with that because it looks weird. If you go to the product page, so that's the default header, right? And I'll add transparent header on my inner page, it will look very weird. But if you guys still want that feature, if you guys have banner showing up all over your website, you can enable transparent header on inner pages as well. It's very simple to do that. So I'll go back to my code. So that's the code which we added. That's the code which we added. So basically what it's doing is it's checking that template is indexed, meaning it first checked that if it's homepage, and it checks the schema setting that if it's enabled. Remember, we added the schema. So it checks that if schema is enabled, it will add this following CSS. And for color, I have created this check here. So it will check that there is a color added and the template, meaning the page is indexed. It will add the following CSS code. And this CSS code is responsible to change the color of icons and menu, etc, etc. And this particularly media query is for mobile version, so it doesn't change the color of mobile menu. So you guys have noticed, if I go to the transparent header here and switch to the mobile version, you can see it doesn't change the color to white to this mobile drawer menu. This is because the media query which I have added here, right? And now if you want to enable this transparent header to all of your website, not just the homepage, you can simply remove this and template is equal to index. So let me remove that and remove this. Now transparent header will be enabled throughout the website. Again, it's not gonna look good because I haven't yet have all of the banners throughout the website. I just have it on the homepage. So all you have to do is just remove this condition and hit save. And now transparent header will be showing up on the complete website. Okay, you can see the transparent header is enabled. It's just that I don't have banner on my collection page here. That's why it looks a little weird. But if we add that banner to my collection page, it's gonna look good. So guys, I have added the banner, and let's open that in new tab. So I paused the video and showed you guys how the transparent header will look on the collection page. So that's how it will look. So that's my all products collection page. And that's how the transparent header will look if you have the banner on the transparent header. If you don't have the banner on inner pages, I don't suggest you guys implement this transparent header tutorial on all of your pages. And that's it for the tutorial, guys. It took a little long to explain everything in code. I'm gonna try my best to explain codes which I'm providing you guys, so you will require less help from the developer and you will be able to try everything on your own. So it will be a complete DIY. Do it your own videos. And until next video, guys, have a great day.